Hi, my name is Alyssa Sonic.
And I'm Leah Goodwin.
And we're going to be your alpaca matchmakers today. Our first match is Dallas and Bethany. Dallas is a white Surrey alpaca who loves dogs, especially puppy, and his red flag is that he uses Tinder.
This is Bethany. She's a beige Surrey alpaca. She loves long walks around the pasture because who doesn't?
And so the reasons we love matching Dallas and Bethany, we think they're going to be a great match. First off, we think that based on the lineage of Bethany and Dallas, which show really strong white fiber traits, that we can assume that their offspring will also turn out to be white. Although she is beige, her lineage has very strong white traits, including her parents and grandparents. So we should be good there. First off, their EPD, for Dallas, we don't have data. We only have an EPD chart, but we still think that his results are pretty promising. We do have data for Bethany's, and we have her EPD chart. So we use that information to pair them together. Bethany's her AFD is very low. It's at a 26.3, which is a really good number. And her EPD shows that her offspring would decrease by at least one more point. So it would be around 25. And Dallas's also decreases, so that's promising. For the standard deviation, Bethany has a really good standard deviation. It's pretty close to 5, and it shows based on her EPD that it'll continue to decrease in her offspring. And then for percent fibers greater than 30 microns, Bethany has a pretty low percentage of 14, and both her and Dallas's EPD show that this will decrease by around 6 to 7% in their offspring, which is pretty good. And then for percent modulation, she has very low percent modulation, and we see that that will decrease as a result of Dallas and her as well, and her comfort factor is very high. So Dallas didn't have comfort factor data, but we can be assured that it'll probably be a pretty good number.
So this is our compatibility charts. As you can see here, all of their traits are actually going to either increase or they're going to level out. And the reason I say this is because Dallas over here has one of the best traits we have for his physical traits. And then over here, Bethany, the only thing I can really see that being a hindrance is her 2.5, but that's going to rise because his luster is a 5. So we're hoping that will be around 3 or 4. And then the uniformity of micron here will also go up, not as much, but it should increase by a little bit.
Our second pair is Tikkanui and Cleopatra. Tikkanui is a white Surrey alpaca, and his favorite food is hay.
This is Cleopatra. She's a medium silver Surrey alpaca, and her favorite pastime is gossiping with her besties.
So Tikkanui's AFD is 29.2, which is really close to 30. That's a pretty good number. Cleopatra's is a little bit higher, so we expect that those numbers will average out. We do note that Cleopatra is a medium silver alpaca, while Tikkanui is white, and Tikkanui has a very strong white lineage, while Cleopatra has, she has some white in her great-grandparents, and she has some gray and black, so we expect that the white traits, if she has any like hidden white traits, that those will come out, but if not, we'll have something in between. For the SD, they have Tikkanui has a really low number, and Cleopatra has almost twice his standard deviation, so that'll balance out somewhere in between. For the fibers, again, her fibers greater than 30 microns, she has about double the percentage. Her numbers aren't too great, but Tikkanui's are pretty good, and that'll balance out. And then for the comfort factor, Tikkanui has a significantly higher comfort factor, so we think that those traits will balance out pretty well.
The reason we use Tikkanui here instead of Zen, which is our best alpaca, is because we want to make sure the future breeding process goes easily, and we don't want to have any problems in the future with that.
Yes.
So we have Tikkanui here because he has very good numbers. Even if they're not as great as Zen's, they're still doable for Cleopatra.
Yeah, so we did use only one male per female.
So this is our compatibility. As you can see, everything on Cleopatra's side is going to increase because of Tikkun Nui. So that's why I was saying earlier, Tikkun Nui just does very fine getting all of her numbers back up. Even though his numbers aren't the best, they still go up, especially at that luster, which I think is a very important point. That will definitely increase by his luster of 4.
Alright, our third match is Arrow and Melanie. Arrow is a bay black Surrey alpaca. He thinks he's a stud, and his red flag is that he's sort of arrogant.
This is Milano. She is a true black Surrey alpaca, and she's very expensive and loves attention, but I don't think that'll be a problem.
So this match, one of the first things we looked at here was color, because although we don't have a history on Milano's color, we have a strong black history on Arrow's color, so we can expect that their offspring would keep those black fiber traits, and that would be good. In addition to this, they have some outstanding numbers, especially for dark colored fiber. So both of their AFDs are under 30. Melanie's is a little closer to 30, but it'll decrease as a result of Arrow's. And then they have actually an identical standard deviation, which is a pretty good number too. Their fiber is greater than 30 microns. Considering that they have dark fur, this is a good number. And Milano's is a little bit higher, but it will balance out with the 26%. And then for the comfort factor, they have, I would say, a pretty good comfort factor, again, for dark fiber. And hers is a 65, he's at a 74, so it would balance around a 70%.
So this is their compatibility for all their physical traits. As you can see, their numbers aren't exactly too far away. I'd like to point out the uniformity of color here, because Milano has 0 and then Arrow has 3. So either way, that is going to increase. That's why we put them together in the first place, is because although they have very similar numbers, their offspring is going to result very well from this. Their luster goes up by a little bit, and so does their uniformity of micron. And since they have like more medium numbers, we're hoping that in the future, as they keep breeding with other alpacas, their numbers will go up altogether.
Our fourth match is Zen and Sansa. So Zen is a white Surrey alpaca. His favorite thing to do is meditate in the mornings, and he is just going with the flow.
This is Sansa. She is a white Surrey alpaca. She has very high standards, and she will only date judge's choice, but we won't have a problem with that for Zen.
Our AFDs are very low. I think this is our favorite pair. These are the alpacas that we deem to be the best, and we paired them together. So Zen has a pretty low AFD, and Sansa's is really low. So they have very fine fiber. Their standard deviation is really close to 5 as well. Zen's is a 5.8 and Sansa's is a 5.1. So that'll balance out pretty well, close to 5. So we know that their fiber will be pretty consistent and pretty fine. And then fiber is greater than 30 microns. Zen has a 19%. And Sansa has an 8.3%, so that'll balance very well. And then we also have a high comfort factor on both of them, a 91.7 on Sansa, which is amazing, and that'll increase Zen's 81 to around, so that they'll be around 85%.
So with their compatibility, I like to point out that their numbers are already very high, some of the best in the whole alpacas that we have here. But even so, they still do see an increase by being matched together. So that fineness is going to go up because her fineness is a 5, and so is the lock structure and the uniformity of micron. And I think this one's important for them too, because his number is not, although it's not a 5, it's very close. So we're hoping that when they get breeded together, that their offsprings in the future will have great numbers.
Good match. We have Torpedo and White Gold. Torpedo is a white Surrey alpaca. He thinks he's a track star. He's a track star, and his red flag is that he thinks he's a racehorse.
This is White Gold. She is a white Surrey alpaca. She's a Gemini and a vegetarian, and make sure you know this, her favorite color is pink, not gold.
Torpedo's AFD is under 30, which is a great sign, and so is White Gold's. It's pushing with a 29.9, but we see that it will decrease when balanced out with Torpedo's, so keeping those numbers under 30. His SD is very low. Hers is like mediocre, I would say, but it'll decrease to match the 5.3 a little closer. For fibers over 30 microns, Weigold has almost 40%, and Torpedo has a 25.6, so that'll be a good match. It'll decrease that a little bit. And then comfort factor, Torpedo has a pretty high comfort factor, and White Gold's is a little bit lower. He's got a 74 and she's got a 61, so that'll balance out pretty well, I think. And then we don't have percent modulation on Torpedo, but we have a like a medium low number for percent modulation on White Gold.
So for their compatibility, I'd like to point out that they have very similar traits here. And we're hoping that they'll even out, because although they are low, we paired them together because we wanted them all to have like a good chance at breeding in the future, and we do believe that these two would make a good pair. So right here at that luster, we're hoping that this will go up because his luster is 3. So because her luster is so low, when Torpedo and her breed, we're hoping that it goes up to at least around a 2. And then the uniformity of Micron will also rise, as well as the long structure.
Alright, and then Sundance and Cleopatra makeup are a bad match. Sundance is a light silver gray Surrey alpaca. He hates gossip, would rather go tanning, and his red flag is that he can't see because hair is better than vision.
And this is Cleopatra, we already mentioned her. And I'd like to say that the physical traits between these two, although they, like, so we saw the other alpacas, and their alpacas had very good traits, they fall short in comparison. So Cleopatra and Sundance, like every single one in every category, they fell short in the physical traits. So that's one of the reasons why we don't want these two together, and also that they share the same dad.
Yeah, so when we look at their data for their fiber traits, we just end up with some pretty bad numbers if we mate them together. So the AFD of Sundance is 31.3, that's already over 30. Cleopatra's is 36.5, which is pretty high compared to the other alpacas. So we know that the AFD for their offspring would definitely be over 30, which is not a good sign. The standard deviation is very high on both of them. It's an 8.6 for Sundance and a 12.7 for Cleopatra. So that would also be a high number, which shows not only thicker fiber, but inconsistency. And then we also have fibers greater than 30 microns. Sundance has a 46.7%, which is really high. It's almost 50% fibers greater than 30 microns, and Cleopatra would make that even higher with her 62.9. So that's just not good results for their offspring. And the comfort factor for Sundance is pretty low at a 53.3, and Cleopatra's is a 37.1, which would decrease it even further. So those are just not good signs if we were to pair them together.
So for the compatibility here, as you can see, all the numbers are pretty low. They're definitely lower than the other alpacas. There's definitely here, the luster might rise a little bit, and so will the uniformity of Micron, but not by much. So we don't see very much hope for their future offspring.
That's it.
Thank you.